Hey, ladies and gents, how you all doing? This is Khan, we're coming to you with another delicate game of warfare between the OKW up here in the north, played by Patient in the Blue Trunks, and in the south, spawning on that lovely map known as Langreskaya, it is Unknown Legend, who, by virtue of the fact that he's in this replay, will now be a known legend in the Red Trunks playing the United States Forces. He is definitely bringing along a different commander than usual. We do see the mechanized company, that withdraw and refit thing, always kind of fun. As well as tax support company and heavy cav. So, being very, very unique initially and then going right back to the old boring stuff. Now, Patient up here in the north, he is bringing along some other kind of more standard commanders, fortifications, special ops, and Luftwaffe ground forces. Even more interestingly, he is coming out with two, count them, Un, deux, or in this case, since he's German, eins, zwei, Kubelwagen. Which is not Kubelwagens, I guess, for a plural, but that's neither here nor there. Kind of an interesting idea, though. I mean, if you think about it, this guy is looking to get a lot of early map pressure. Although, that power is going to drop off super quick the second that Unknown Legend gets either grenades, or really just kind of flanks him. Or just uses rifles, or really does anything, so maybe not a great idea to start off with two Kubelwagen. But it could be unique, until, of course, Unknown Legend goes for that mechanized company and brings in the 50 cal truck. So this bad boy, which can very, very easily become a clown car, and looks like it's one of the most underrated pieces of equipment in American movie cinema, especially for World War II is concerned. This thing is a beast against stuff like the Kubelwagen. So this garrison right here with rifle in it, oh, it's suddenly now free. Look, it's got a giant whopping machine gun on it, and these Strompios are going to get shot to pieces. There is a Volkswagen on the field, but unfortunately for him, he's not going to be able to pop any Panzerfaust for quite a bit of time until he actually gets another headquarters, and that's not coming on for, well, considering the meta these days, unless things get super, super dire. Not coming out for quite a bit of time. Also, unfortunately, while he does have, he being Patient, does have his fuel in supply, he also took the time to capture this fuel and then did not put it in supply. So maybe not the best decision there, but, you know, he's just asking us all to be patient. Buckle up, guys. We've got a long ways to go. There's going to be more jokes about that if I can make them. Clown car moves around to the east, but right now, Unknown Legend is definitely putting a little bit of a truth to his name by not really taking this so seriously. Also, for some strange reason, this truck is firing at the Volksgrenadiers as opposed to the Kubelwagen, which would just be shredded by that bad boy. And now that it's taking fire, that first Kubelwagen, it really should consider moving and getting out of there, especially not getting flanked by some other riflemen. So, very, very different openings than what we're used to here, and leading to a very, very big engagement in the middle part of the map. And shockingly, neither Kubelwagen is below half health just yet. And instead, we are going to see some riflemen getting forced back away, and this 50 cal truck kind of dancing around, not really doing a whole lot. Now, with Raketen on the field, that truck is very, very, very outdated. How expensive is that bad boy again? 240 and 20, yes. In the opening part of the game, I'm not sure I'd really go for mechanized company for absolutely no other reason than just because you really can use that fuel a little bit more effectively as you go into the game. But we can't malign Unknown Legend too much. He does have an army, let's say, composition advantage at the moment. Maybe not in terms of just raw size. The main Patient is a teensy tiny bit ahead. But nevertheless, four squads of riflemen will beat basically two squads of infantry any day, and the Kubelwagen on there as well. Even more so when the Strompios find themselves caught out in the open while trying to repair. So maybe not the best opportunity there, but you know what? He's learning. He's learning. We're getting through it. And you know, for the mechanized regiment headquarters, and again, not sure I'd go necessarily for that one, considering how easy it is for my troops to get mauled by some of this American firepower on the map. We will see that truck has been pulled back, but to where is the question? I don't know. Over to the east, perhaps? Yes, there it is. And they're going to decap that fuel and recap it for the good of the old US of A. And indeed, even leaving open the middle part of that map, though, for these riflemen to kind of come up nice, close and personal, and now find themselves under a curtain of fire. I'm surprised not just bolting out of there. Soft retreat instead. Not the best option, but I guess he's a little concerned about losing models or really losing his map presence. And we're finally going to see it fall back. Not really accomplishing a whole lot by staying up there to fight just a wee bit longer. Though he has forced all the OKW forces into the center part of this map. I'm also shocked to see that no squad of those three took a negative cover, malice, or penalty on that one. But you know what? He is going how he's going to go. Question is now, will Patient just kind of hang out and take his time, if you know what I mean, so that way he can go and get himself a Panzer II? I don't know if that's the greatest option. That thing's going to be quite a ways off. Another 2 minutes easily. And with the riflemen on the field right now, capping out probably about, 60-70% of that map, the Germans do kind of need to get a little bit on their horse here, both to cap out these strategic MVPs, but also to push back this center jagged portion that's been kind of thrown into the German position. We are going to see an early Shrek coming out for the Shrimpios. A little bit surprising, not something you tend to see very often. But maybe he's just trying to make sure that he doesn't lose out against the things like that early Stuart if his opponent was rushing for that. But shockingly still, this... Oh, never mind. Oh my gosh. I was going to say that was such a giant waste of munitions, but that puts it pretty well set right there. So congratulations. Those guys have medical supplies. And I also do have... Did they get that kill on the vehicle? Is that theirs? Yep, they get the kill on that vehicle. Kupelwagen now is going to come under fire from the western side, and really what's left for the Americans is now just a captain who still doesn't have his weapons on him. And bringing in a 57mm to somehow kind of pick up the slack there. In the east, we're seeing the Americans getting thrown back on all fronts, that machine gun being brought to the fore, and really putting up a curtain that's devastating the American positions. Now, this fighting position right here might be enough to actually hold back the German tide, if absolutely nothing else, for just a few seconds. And indeed, actually, if these rear echelons got into the fighting position, they might be able to effectively combat this German push. Now, unfortunately for them, this captain runs right smack dab into this machine gun, and this Raketenwerfer, despite being coming under fire, will likely take out... Oh, never mind, pinned. Oh my gosh, so close yet so far. Captain was pinned, but so was the Raketenwerfer. And that fighting position lives for another day. Question is now, are those guys going to run inside? No, they're going to repair it, it looks like, instead. And what happened, a German map is starting to kind of seesaw back and forth. But with the addition of this Panzer II, and just the soft AT of the captain with this very rather immobile 57mm, I have to be a little bit nervous for the American positions right now, because no, they have actually not picked up the grenade package, despite having more than enough fuel for it, and really having more than enough reason to, oh my gosh, but then, you know, when stuff like that happens, it's hard to really be harsh again and again. Though we can't say that, Panzer II being on the map has already made its presence felt, 3 kills, and can easily be pushing back the Americans, wherever that 57mm isn't. And it seems the Americans know that too. They're bringing themselves into Stuart, and for some reason, I don't know why, but I just thought literally of that, you know, the Stuart Little, the little mouse, I guess, the movie from a few years back. And when you think about a Stuart tank, you kind of think about the same thing with him too. You know, he's small, he's spunky, but, you know, can't really stand up to playing with the big boys. We are going to see the incendiary grenade popping out over on this garrison over here, and will be a bit of a problem for the Americans, at least in the immediate fighting positions. But this fighting position over here does have those rear echelons inside, so they're going to be throwing out all that delicious, delicious rifle grenade goodness. And the western side, we did see the captain almost go down. Probably see this fighting position go down another round or so. Barely just not happening. We almost saw the captain go down, and instead we're actually going to see the steward announce its presence, and with those Sturm Pios right there, I'm not sure that's a great idea. Yes, we are going to see some death and destruction being visited upon. The Panzer II might even take it out. Will that be the case? Yep, it will. They will probably take it out. Just kind of sitting here playing tanks at 20 paces here. One more round. Can we see one more round? Will it be the God round from Eponema? No, it won't. Instead, it's going to be a Panzer II lost for nothing, unfortunately, and this 57mm decrewed as well. So horror of horrors, the American position is carved to shreds. They did, very, very briefly, have a bright, shining moment of glory when that steward came on to take out the Panzer II, and continue to have a little bit more as they're starting to devastate the German infantry, but a Puma and those two Kupelwagens are still on the map. It's still going to be a little bit of an issue here, especially since now literally all they have for anti-tank is this little old captain here. And the Captain Apu over here is not going to be able to handle it all by his lonesome. Impatient, though, for his own particular peace of mind, is going to call in a Puma on the off chance his opponent does go for another Stuart, and that is going to be the repaired Stuart coming back on the map. Puma, and with the Puma in play, and the Stuart as well. Where is that airstrike coming in, actually? Airstrike? Recon sweep? Not an airstrike. Why did it say airstrike? That is just patently bad marketing. Now, this Puma up here to the north is kind of a non-standard pick. Usually you will see OKW players being less concerned about hanging in tier 2 instead of finding themselves pushing forwards into a more aggressive position, whether that's to tech up all the way to the Sheriff Panzer headquarters or whatever the case might be. Just a very, very non-standard pick for our German player here. And that grenade almost comes in and does almost take out those Volksgrenz, but instead we will see this Puma probably will pick off this Stuart in another round or two. Yes, he does have an engine damage crit on him now, but yep, there goes the Stuart. He is definitely down, he is definitely out, and there ain't nothing that's going to be done here except this 57mm, which is now obligingly had this Puma placed into its crosshairs. Question is he out of that firing arc? No, he's not, and he's out of control. Yikes. Yikes. So as he kind of does a little dance for the last second or two, then he falls down to pieces. So neither player really playing a particularly strong game so far. We do see just very, very minimal approaches for both sides of the aisle, but this fighting position is surprisingly enough hanging out way, way longer than I thought it would. Usually you don't see fighting positions hold out this long. They're kind of there and gone almost as soon as they hit the map. Mostly because it cries out, "Please hit me with indirect fire!" Maybe not that kind of a effeminate voice, perhaps, but maybe it's more like, "Bro, hit me. I could take it." And after a while they realize they can't take it. But by then it's too late and they can't quite recover. What we will see happen, see these captain moving over here to the western side again, trying to pick on this Kupelwagen. There's a second Panzer II coming out, so I'm not sure it's really the best option to be choosing it the way he is. But Patient is just taking his time. He's biding his time. He's going to sacrifice the Kupelwagen, it seems, in just a second here. Zook shot comes in, takes off 1/3 health right there. And this little fire point of German troops is not going to be enough to really be pushing everybody back. And indeed, although right now it is a 2-1 cap. And this... Yep, there it goes. The Kupelwagen now is out on the map. It'll be kind of fun for me to see an American Kupelwagen, a captured Kupel. But instead, what we will see, this Volksgrenz squad has just kind of come down and picked off that 57mm crew yet again. I mean, that gun is cursed, my friends. It is indeed cursed. Now, what is also cursed, though, is pretty much any kind of German troop on the map. He is there, they are gone. It kind of just, it doesn't seem to matter what the particular position is. Of course, I do say that, and that Panzer II comes in, storms in, and might even be able to take out... No, it's not going to. I thought it was going to take out that rear echelon squad, but it turns his attention to the fighting position, and probably has a better idea in the long run. Unknown Legend, in the meantime, though, does go and grab himself a mortar, sort of playing back into the meta, but really, really super out of order and really, really super late. And 50 minutes into the game, though, you wouldn't know by the ticket count right now. 439 to 377, and this Panzer II is just diving for the gaps. Not entirely sure why, necessarily. But with a 2-1 cap right now, 439 to 375, you can't really be making too much fun of him. It's very much an FU push coming out from this Panzer II, and he's going to take a Zug shot or two. Not sure if he's trying to just actually destroy these bunkers, because it's going to take a lot longer than that. And indeed, that 57mm just manages to squeak a shot by. Doesn't quite hit him. The Panzer II's got a new lease on life. He's been hired to kill that man's daughter. He's got a new appreciation for life. But it seems that Unknown Legend is going to try to have another trick up his sleeve. He has just called in that Major, though neither player has really, really been having consistent long-term control of these fuel points. I think Patient has finally been able to, you know, really lock down the eastern side of the map, but it seems almost more because his opponent hasn't really pushed forward as opposed to him really managing to do it all by himself. Mortar team does get caught out by this very, very wounded squad of Volksgrenz. He's got to book it out of there. I would run, my friend. There we go. He's going to get out of there right now. And finally, another squad of Sturmpaus is coming on the map, as well as a Stukas of Fuss. So very, very interesting pick. One that gets overlooked an awful lot here. But with a couple of barrages, he could change the balance of this game. And frankly, there's not a whole lot of heavy material on the map. Raketen has apparently gone down a long time ago. Forgive me guys for missing that one. And it seems this Shrek Storm might as well. No, they don't. Phew! Squeaking out an escape. But these Volks may not. Suddenly more guys get turned into bloody, bloody mist. And that mortar definitely didn't miss. I can tell you that much. But this machine gun in the house just continues to be a bugaboo over here. He's got that for your echelons pinned. He gets the rifleman kind of locked down. Captain's going to try to take out this middle VP. And although the machine gun is wide open, never mind. He's going to be able to do so because that machine gun is wide open. And he's going to squeak out an escape, though, and his team's just in time. Stukas of Fuss, though, he is on the map. Question is, what's he going to shoot at first? That's like the wild world of Wonka. But if he runs that far forward, he's going to get hammered. Oh, God. Oh god, oh god. He fires one rocket and then bolts. Good idea. Question is, where does he fire it? Oh my gosh, but that one rocket does exactly what he needs it to. Kaboom, kaboom. He bolts and still does that. That actually might be like a perfect, like, you know, SportsCenter top 10 right there. Might have to remember that. And in fact, guys, I have now remembered that. I just made a mark for that. I'm looking to put together a little bit of a Company of Heroes 2 top plays. Be on the lookout for that as well. There's a lot of things going on in the channel, to be perfectly frank. Wow, a new Volks? A new Kubrakan, rather? Apparently, yes. But apparently, Patient wants a very, very mobile, very, very light, aggressive force. And to be fair, he's doing a pretty good job with it, although he is getting out-rotated currently, as his infantry tends to be very, very blobbed. Where is that? Oh my gosh, the 155 came in over here, trying to take out stuff back in base, but doesn't do a whole lot. Oh no, he does take out the Stukas of Fuss. Oh my gosh, so having perfect accuracy means your opponent is super, super scared. So Unknown Legend throws 180 munitions and manages to take out a very, very important linchpin of his opponent's current army, but doesn't be doing his troops a whole lot of good over here in the west. Surprised that this rifle squad is not pulled out just yet. No, he's going to back away just barely in time, and despite his troops fighting the good fight, it does seem that Patience's men might have just run out. No, this Sturmpower is for sure almost going to go down. Yep, there he goes, and he drops a Shrek. In fact, he drops two Shreks, although only one of those is any kind of good. That's a big problem, because the Panzer Shrek, at least historically, was a far, far better anti-tank weapon. At least the M1 bazooka. It wasn't until the M9, I think, that the shell really got upgunned and became a legitimate force against Axis armor. It does seem that this captain's going to run afoul of the Panzer II, which will probably bring a rotation of some of these rifle squads. No, he's not worried about that, apparently. Apparently he's more worried about capping out the center VP, and frankly, down 140 VPs, or 140 tickets, rather, I can understand why. Now, what is unfortunate as well, though, is that every single time that the Allies take out a German vehicle, they don't take out the wreck, they just kind of take out the vehicle, which allows all that yummy, yummy salvage to happen. When salvage happens, ain't nobody going to be happy with that one. Captain in the center, excuse me, rifle in the center part of the map. I thought it was a captain because of the Zook, but no, it is a, oh my gosh. It's a brutal shot, that is. Is that the hyper shot? No, it's not hyper shot. It is hyper shot. There we go. Armor piercing, discarding sable rounds. We're starting to see some engagements all across the map. These Volksgrenz squads got to back off, though. That mortar finally starting to pay dividends in the long term. And once that Sherman comes on the field, the Germans really do have to watch out. They're not going to have any sort of armored vehicle for quite some time. Senior grenade comes out on top of these riflemen, and it looks like they will do a fair amount of damage. It does back them away, though. Question is, can they stay out of that explosive round by that mortar? So far, they're okay. They might be able to cap that out before getting forced away. I have to say one thing. I'm very impressed that Patient has not been pushed off the map by all of the Allied infantry. He's been outnumbered in quite a bit in terms of infantry. Doesn't look like it right now, necessarily, but Captain's no slouch on the map, and considering how many times he's recrewed that 57mm, can't be too harsh about that, can we? Of course, now with the Sherman on the map, this machine gun is finally going to get pushed away from the western side of it, and really needs to book it out of there, otherwise they could drop a very, very vital piece of equipment. But no, luckily enough, they get away before that HE takes them out of commission. Doesn't mean that things are coming on Milhouse necessarily for the Americans. They do seem to slowly push their way back towards the center of the map. But it also does look like the Germans are trying to lure out that Sherman, which has a very, very interesting color choice towards it. With a gun mantle, it having a bit of a yellow patch on it. It's like screams, shoot me here, shoot me here. Tragically, a lot of the areas on the tank that would be seen as maybe armored are not so garishly painted. Rifleman out in the open, though, going to be like, okay, we got this, bros, we got this. And the Panzer II comes up, puts three rounds into him, and inspires them to leave. But if this 57... that Panzer II is going to say going to charge further any... try this again. That Panzer II is going to move forward anymore. He was going to get picked off by the gun line at 57mm anti-tank guns. In the meantime, the Sherman thinks, yo, bro, I got this then. No problem here, son. And shockingly, Major manages to escape by without taking too much fire from that surviving Strempire squad. And indeed, this might see the turnaround for the Americans that they needed.
We're losing a capture point.
Then again, if there is this unique position moving forward, oh, that's why, because this Raketenwerfer has not set to prioritize vehicles. And that's a big mistake right there. That's a giant mistake indeed.
Frontline units are being hung out to dry.
While I want to complain a lot about some of the micro that might be going on here, one thing I cannot complain about is Patient's decisions in terms of capping. He's capping in very, very unique, very, very vital areas of the map for his opponent. He's cutting off the entire western side of it right now and basically hampering, incredibly, his opponent's resource generation. Yes, it will cost him, and you'll see that happen here as his Volksgrenz are going to get butchered, I'm sure. Yeah, you gotta book out of there right now, big guy. Book it. Book it like Expedia. There we go. Cool. And now it starts to back away. Good idea. And indeed, is it that his... What the heck? Oh my gosh. 57mm are looking to find that Schwerpanzer headquarters and might be able to do so. And if they do, that is a massive, massive victory for Unknown Legend. Another thing, guys, to pay attention to, though, is that make sure you turn your Schwerpanzer headquarters in the right direction. It will decrease the amount of time it takes to rotate around and start firing at an opposing armored vehicle. really anything for that matter. But it is going to go down, and that tank's going to 800 experience for it. The question is, can he get an engine crit perhaps from this Raketen? No, he makes it out of there okay. Although we are going to see ourselves another Stukas Afus, and this Panzer II refuses to be cowed by the fact that there's a Sharon on the line as well as those 257mm. Only 6 kills. But by gosh, does he put the fear of God in them whenever he's around. Well, the fear of the Fuhrer, perhaps. I'm not entirely sure which way you want to look at that one. But 25-35 into this game, and you can't really argue with the results that he's had so far, despite having a very, very minimal army comp, and a very, very light one at that. Patient is still up almost 200 VPs, 430 to 263 right about now, and although the Americans will start to drain out just a teeny tiny bit here, there's going to be a second Raketen on the field, which means that Sherman will not be able to charge too quickly, and a second Stukas Afus, it'll be more than enough to really be shelling a lot of this. And oh my god, could this be this could be a god barrage right here. Oh my gosh. Okay, so he savages a couple of squads, almost takes out the ambo, and I could have sworn he was going to take out the mortars as well. Does a fair amount of damage there, and will be forced to back away soon enough. And the 57mm grants a new lease of life to this particular Kubelwagen by throwing a last warning shot over his bow. A super, super late... Okay, there we go. Has the machine gunner been killed? I dare say he has. The main gun, yes. Yes, the MG42 of it all has just been walloped. Could we see a ambo raid? Oh my gosh, he's got to see it. No, he's not going to deal with those. He's going to start taking on this 57mm instead. Never mind. I could have sworn he was going to be able to pick up that 57mm, but he's not going to do that. Instead, it looks like he's going to almost even drop that squad. Is he going to get out in time? He is. I was going to say, you can't argue with the results that Patient has been getting. Playing a very methodical, very light composition on this map. He's been able to take and keep control of the game for a fair bit of time here. And yes, I know you can make the case that his opponent is mismicroing some things here and there. There have also been some micro mistakes on his part as well, and yet he still is in an excellent position. Strong Pios, though, really should back out here. He's got absolutely no health, and really should just be thrown down. There we go. Good idea. Let's back out of there right now. Now, riflemen are like, yo, bro, I got this, and then charge and realize the Panzer II is there and realize, yo, bro, I don't got this, and book it for the high hills. Second Sherman, though, is going to be placed on the map soon enough. Main gun destroyed, and it gets brewed up. Never mind, there it goes. Tries in vain to throw out a smoke round, but instead gets baited in and cut off by that anti-tank line. This I'm a little concerned about, though. This is sloppy play. Patient, my friend, you really do need to have either the medic station on there, which seems like you're finally putting now, or to build the medical supplies for your troops. Captain, in the meantime, is going to run afoul of this machine gun, and I want to know when that next Stukas Afus barrage is going to come in. I get the feeling he's kind of nervous about his troops getting hammered by another... Never mind, it's not going to happen. No, it's never going to see rockets away. Follow the shadows. Where are the shadows going to fall? Oof. Oof. So despite almost hammering his own squads into oblivion, this Raketen for first plug, another shot off. No, instead it gets decrewed. Unlucky there. Volksgrenz charge forward is maybe trying to force away the Sherman somehow. Not entirely sure on that one. And instead we're going to see them just cap out that middle VP as the Panzer II calmly just kind of notes, hey look, there's a lot of Allied infantry here. I'm also going to think that we're going to lose some German infantry soon. It's got to happen at some point. And indeed, that mortar has paid dividends for itself, so much so that Unknown Legend is trying to increase his myth by calling in another mortar. And now a pack howitzer as well. So Unknown Legend realizing that he's got the direct engagement victory. The question is, can he use his indirect fire enough and effectively to really be locking down his opponent in this late game. Patient, for his own particular decision, does finally decide to go for that fortifications doctrine. Not entirely sure why at this point, unless he's going to start building a howitzer or something like that, which could be a lot of fun. You just don't see that often enough these days. I don't think the Pac-43 would be a particularly great option. I think it's going to get flanked way too easy on this map. It's just too wide open. If it was something a little more confined, like the eastern side of Angoville, then you could be much more readily able to use that material. Medics are brought in, but yet this Sturmpire squad does not have the health to support this particular push. It does bother me a little bit. Stukas of Fus can shoot any time now. He's going to wait for that to happen. And indeed, we're going to see this Panzer II just kind of chilling over here to the west. While the Allies do take out the east, which is kind of shocking, considering they had just not been able to cap anything out there for such a long time. This Sturmpire squad could go down to one unlucky hit. I really don't like that particular play right now by Patient. STG Volks, though, are trying to duke it out with a BAR and have a slight numbers advantage, and will be able to do so just for the moment. At least until these mortars start firing, and just any second you'll see these rounds start pouring in on them. That'll just be very, very sad. I cannot but wonder, is this an attempt by Patient to draw out his enemy's indirect fire sources? It does kind of seem so. He is moving forward with that Stuka and barrage away. Even if he's even moderately effective at this particular round, he could really devastate. Okay, there goes one. The other mortar does not take any hits, but regardless, to firing another particular barrage, I had to be very, very impressed with Patient's usage of indirect fire so far on this map. His Stuka accuracy has been on point. Okay, mostly on point. I mean, the barrage down here was not stellar. Really, the question that remains for him is, can he fight off... Oof. There goes a Kubelwagen right there. That's just unfortunate. Can he fight off the Shermans is really the question. And he's moving forward his own Rakettens in a vain attempt, I think, to try to somehow find it. I don't know. He will seem very, very content to just throw rounds at this 57mm, though, which is kind of humorous when you think about it. And the 57mm is going to try to back it away and will encourage the Rakettens to book it out of there. And I really do wonder, why is Patient mounting Fortifications Doctrine? I would have thought he would have gone for something a little bit more aggressive at this point, but even Special Operations Doctrine would have been an excellent decision to really be laying into his opponent with some late-game call-ins, such as that Panzer Command Tank. And the Volk Squad does go down, cutting Patient's infantry down by a third, and that's just, yeah, you can't... That will be something I will have to note a little bit deficient in Patient's play, is that you cannot allow yourself to be left on such minimal army compositions. Panzer II, of course, as you do see, has gone down. Question is really, when's Stukas of Fus going to fire? It's going to be any second now, I'm sure of it. Impatient is floating a fair bit of manpower as well as fuel, as well as munitions for that matter. So what the heck is he going to be doing with this? He's just not using it at all. To get back into this game, you don't want to go and try to bring in another headquarters at this point. Like, that's definitely true. Oh, I know he's going to go. He's going to go for that Tiger. KT, all day. Question is, can he hold out long enough for it? He's under a chip cap right now, and his infantry is lagging badly. P-47 spun up and ready for reconnaissance. And perhaps realizing how far behind he is, he's trying to bring in some more, some P-Grens, and probably going to put a double Shrek on them to really be pushing away the Allied armor as best as he can. Damage engine is going to go down on top of that Sherman, and really the Sturmpires could be rushing forward to try to take these guys out. It would take a lot of damage to do so, though. And unfortunately for the Germans, the Stukas of Fus barrage takes out the garrison, but nothing else. Okay, so the Rakettens are going to get thrown into the fray. It looks like they're going to be this... Oh my gosh, no, my friends!
shoot at the tank. If you could take out the tank, that crew is worthless. But being repaired, you really have to worry about how often... There we go, never mind, it brews up, and there they go.
Volks is going to go down. Actually, that's a replacement Volks, too, so that was just a giant kind of sad waste. And 35 minutes in, what had looked rather dire for the Americans seems to be all better now. Good lord, he's holding, like, what, 85% of the map, 95% of the map right now? Probably get to the point that really, yep, he is just shelling that home base right now. Insult to injury, decrews one of the Rakettans, another crew coming under fire quite a bit. ISG firing back, trying in vain to take these guys out, but I don't even think he knows effectively. He's firing rounds at them, but not effectively. Recon sweep coming in, going to be just as much fun and just as fine for him to see where his rounds are going. And frankly, even with one mortar, that's going to be more than enough to be a giant pain in the rear end. And Jackson is on the field as well. And what a lovely tank that looks like, too. Again, that kind of weird color on the mantlet. And the Germans now vainly trying to get out and just do whatever they can to hold off until they can bring in that Tiger. But I don't think this one's got the distance, folks. Patient have been playing so well and then lost it with having only a couple of infantry squads that really kind of bit him. Stukas Afus any second now? We can fire. Question is where? Will he want to fire in the middle part of the map? I would say so. You know, he could even fire to the eastern side. Doesn't really matter where he shoots. He's going to just aim somewhere. And it appears he's going to go for that mortar. Yep. There we go. The mortar dropping and kind of just evaporate.
We lost a gun crew.
Which is shocking because it will allow the Germans to get back on the map. The question is how effective will this map presence be? Fighting position is now down on the map and got a really, really big firing arc, which means that every single time these Volks are going to come forward, they're going to get torn to shreds. And indeed, now this steward has come forward, another steward rather, I suppose, to a Sherman, my bad. And we'll chase down and probably take out this poor Kupelwagen the next time he pokes his head out of his hidey hole. Now, Sherman pilots come up over here to pick up the mortar, but find themselves just kind of hanging about here. There we go. Decides to get out of there, finally. And veterancy-wise, what happened, a very good position for Patient, like I said, has now dropped off heavily in favor of Unknown Legend. The noble hero desperately trying to return his troops to their former glory. Volksgrenz, 5-star Volksgrenz in the middle part of the map, not a good idea to hang around, and he realizes that now after the fact. I just continue to want to see where these shots land, because every single time that thing fires, it just seems to do so much damage. Germans are threatening a recap on parts of the map, but are very much not going to be able to do so, not with the current presence and current forces that they have. I think at this point, Patient really should just stall out, grab that KT. He's called an all four trucks. He can do it. He has the technology. Of course, if he manages to do that too, at that point, first of all, his opponent really should be bringing in more tanks. Or absolute minimum, more infantry, or absolute minimum, anything, really.
P-47 refuel. We're losing a capture point.
Impatient will probably just go and try to stall out for another minute or so, just so that way he can bring in that tank. And indeed, just kind of speed it up a little bit. One Rakat and Disney crew, if I get taken out by this particular,
yep.
Oh, never mind. Squad comes in. Oh my gosh, never mind. There goes a rifleman squad. And almost, there almost goes the neighborhood as well with that fighting position. Good gosh. And why is he doing this? Patient's calling in another truck. I get it. You like trucks. You and DDR Jake must hang out together, and you guys don't know who that is. Well, watch Paradox Interactive. Definitely a good guy to know. Not sure why he's making that decision, though. Because you've had all four trucks on there, my friend. He's going to waste 125 fuel, and that's going to be all she wrote.
eastern side of the map. The Germans are pushing forwards over here again, trying to cap out as much as possible. Looks like that Mitch is going to throw down his rapid barrage. It's going to hurt. It's going to hurt a lot. Kind of a beautiful visual, though. In a, you know, very, very violent sort of way. But it's still a 1-to-1-to-1 cap, and the Germans really have no one to blame but themselves at this particular moment in this game. But it is also good, though, for Patient that his opponent has not brought forward more heavy support, you know, besides the Jackson kind of hanging over here to the side, to really keep his troops combative. And, of course, as I say that, a round comes in for the pack howitzer, and just kaboom, there goes an entire squad. Is this the whole fake flares? Yep. Okay. But his opponent knows that. He's like, yo, bro, I got that. Are you kidding me? I'm going to push forward, just carve you guys apart. And we'll seem like he'll be able to do that. He is going to take out this captain in just a second, I do believe. I do declare, Laramie. And yep, there goes a captain. There goes a gun crew. And that fighting position is only hanging on by a mere thread. Patient, hombre. You've had this game. Oh no, but he's put his troops inside of this garrison. It's going to be taken out one shot. There they go. There goes the Storm Pios, and there goes 50% of his AT on the map. And I think Patient just kind of lost himself a little bit here. Tosses out tries to toss out a Panzerfaust, doesn't get a chance to do so. Yeah, pretty much a vanilla squad of Volkskrans left on the map, and I don't know how much more he can take. In fact, I'm going to predict that he doesn't take a whole lot more. I would love to see a KT actually have happened about, you know, 5 or 7 minutes ago. This took us a first barrage. Where's it go? And unfortunately, now his accuracy begins to fall as he has no more, let's call them spotters, out on the map. Support gun going to get taken out as well. And what had been, like I said, a very, very strong game from Patient becomes less so. It seems like he lost his patience. Or maybe he was too patient. ISG goes down. Vaketten gets decrewed. The other Vaketten gets decrewed. And all that's left is just a bunch of squats just kind of hanging out in the back here. And frankly, that KT should have been brought in a long time ago. Now it's just making me angry. Patient floating 1,000 manpower. This point really just kind of gifting the game away. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in on this particular game. As Grimpox, I see the last couple of minutes here getting bled out. But thanks so much for tuning in. As always, there we go. We finally see the stupid KT, you know, hours later, really. But I don't think it's going to be enough. And indeed, watch as Volkskrans go down on this particular one. I don't think it has happened just yet, but it probably will. Oh, jeez. If only some of these things had not been investments. Alas, we can only interpret history backwards. We can't interpret it forwards. And we're going to see a sync error coming out here, which means that Patient just kind of said, yo, bro, this, forget it. It's done. So he taps out, 44-15 into this game. Well done to Unknown Legend for keeping his cool. In my mind, not taking the best commander necessarily, but Patient, not sure why he took Fortifications Doctrine. Because he didn't even use any of it. And he had the munitions for it. But folks, thanks so much for tuning in. As always, I appreciate the viewership and I appreciate your feedback. Thanks so much for actually responding to all the questions I gave off in the particular games. If you have a game you want me to check out, please let me know at khanulricgaming@gmail.com, and I will see you all soon. Take it easy, everybody.